in your opinion, what would be the most important factor to get the runner to the start line and then ideally the finish line of their first race?
Sure. Like what would, you know. I think the most important factor, and I believe this is true across the spectrum of runners, is what we would call load management and recovery. And that's just technically what we're doing is managing the exposure to physical stress and then managing your body's ability to come back from that, right? So for a lot of us, you look online and you might see a running program or you might see a runner that does this all the time at whatever level. Mm-hmm. It's very much a culture thing. They're running all the time because people like to run.
Right.
It's just something they enjoy, right? Yeah. And I understand that. You run every day. It's enjoyable if you do it. It's your decompression. It's your stress relief. It's your peace time sometimes.
Right.
You want to do it frequently, or people want to do it frequently. Right. As a beginner, there's an element of risk in that your body hasn't developed the resiliency, the connective tissue in your lower legs and other parts of your body, your right. bones perhaps, your muscles for that matter. They may not have developed the resiliency to take on the stress of running. There's a lot of impact. Every step you take is your body with the forces of gravity pushing it into the ground.
Right.
And your bones and your muscles and your connective tissue, they have to absorb that.
Right.
So finding that recovery and planning out space in between the stress sessions, which would be your training sessions, allows your body to recover. And over time, with that, you become stronger and stronger, and your body is able to resist the stresses, and going for those easy runs here and there, or most days of the week,
right.
becomes manageable and less problematic for the system. But it takes time. Connective tissue sometimes takes 6 to 8 months to develop. And okay. get stronger, right?
So starting with 2 times a week and then progressing after, yeah. like you said, a 6 to 8 month period.
Yeah, definitely.
Increasing that to 3 times a week.
Yes. I've coached many beginner runners that have run twice a week for anywhere from 8 to 16, 20 weeks, and they make amazing progress. They go from not thinking they can run at all, right. thinking that 5K is completely impossible, to running 5K and beyond, right?
Yeah,
and it's just slowly building that house up and building that capacity up, and they get there, and managing that recovery in between.
Yes, so it's important to have someone kind of in your corner too to remind you that the progress is always slow.
Yes.
Like you need to take the time, it's not gonna be an overnight fix.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
A coach and a program's good, sometimes a coach is even better.
A coach with a program is best.
Yeah.
You can't have one of those. Having the plan still helps.
Right.
Having somebody that can get you out of your head is good too.
Right.
One of the things that I'm guilty of this myself, and I've been doing this for years, is one day you feel good and you try to push it. You know, yes. I feel good today. Why not go further? Why not go faster?
Right.
But sometimes those plans progress at an adequate rate that work with your body and what your body needs to get that just a little bit further than what you were before. And you know, trusting the plan that's made by somebody that's got some experience is a good thing. And
yeah.
And you will feel good some days, you will feel bad some days, and just be mindful that you can really easily overdo it if you get going too fast too soon.
Yeah, definitely.